band limiting of the bass band. So in the previous clips we have fixed the amplitude information so that we had good understanding how to code the signal, but now we need to talk about the time essentially. So we need to talk about time and bandwidth. So remember our symbol stream so far was, if this is here our S of T, a real symbol stream, and this S of T is maybe something like that. And so this would be, for example, the 1, this would be a 0, another 0, that's a 1, that's a 0, and that's another 1. And so here we have these very sharp transitions here. So here and here. And so the problem with this is they require infinite bandwidth. Obviously more or less every transmission channel we have in RF has a very limited bandwidth. Think of FM radio, for example, or so, where every channel also has 100 kilohertz bandwidth, for example. Television, maybe 5 megahertz or something like that. And so, but every time, so we need to work with finite bandwidths. So infinite bandwidth is not good. So the reason why this is infinite bandwidth is that essentially these steep edges here, they are creating infinite frequencies. So we need to find a theoretical framework how to limit the bandwidth . So that's an H here, how to limit the bandwidth. And so we start with the idea that we're being quite radical. And we say, okay, we just define our bandwidth as a brick. So that's here our baseband, so that's frequency, and this is here S of F, so that's our bandwidth here, and this is B. So with that we are creating our bandwidth. So just like a brick-like bandwidth. So if we have a brick-like bandwidth, So how does the symbol actually look like? Yeah, so we need to do the inverse Fourier transform of this here. Inverse, that's an R, inverse Fourier transform. And so we just take this brick here and do an inverse Fourier transform. And for those who know what's happening with these brick-like functions here, this comes out as a sinc function. Okay, so let's look into sync functions. So now we've got our brick-like frequency response here. So that's our brick with our bandwidth B. So that's here frequency here, and that's our S of F. So if we transform this back into small S of T, then this gives us a sync function. So mathematically, this is done in the following way. So we are integrating from minus 2 pi b to 2 pi b, so the bandwidth of this, because we also need to take into account the negative frequencies here, so it goes to minus b. And and so we are integrating this and doing an inverse Fourier transform. So that's done by this here. And so we use the angular term here and putting the 2 pi in here. And so the inverse Fourier transform gives us then 1 over pi t, and then sine of 2 pi b t. So that's here the inverse Fourier transform. And so what we are getting out here is our sync function. So this sync function now, this gives us here this S of T, so our symbol. So how does it look like? So if we sketch this here, probably most of you have seen that. So a sync function looks like that. Yeah, so something like a damped sine wave. And so that this has these wiggles to both sides here. So now this one is now nicely band limited here, but with that we have created two new problems here. So we just need to, I just take a new slide here and continue with that. So now with the sync function, I just redraw this here. So that's our S of T, and so that's the shape of our sync function here. I just write the formula here, not 2 pi, just a pi. Pi t multiplied by sine of 2 pi bt, and remember this was our bandwidth. And so now with that, we are having two problems here created by this. Now the bandwidth is nicely limited, but when this function S of T reaches in both sides, so this means it goes to negative infinite time and it goes to positive infinite time. So this means we need to, in order to create this function, the first problem, let's write here problem. So the first problem is that it runs from negative infinite time to positive infinite time. And this is obviously cannot be realized in a real system. So the second problem now is, imagine we are transmitting symbols, and our ideal symbol obviously is something square-like, in the time domain in terms of sampling, so that we are able to sample our symbol information here. So for example, we would like to sample here for a symbol, and then maybe for the next one we would like to sample here. But because the sync function is still there, so we are getting interference. So imagine our next symbol is also now generated by a sync function, and then the next symbol is here. And so obviously at this point here we were getting interference between these two symbols here. So problems, the second problem is we're getting so-called inter-symbol interference. So just because of the fact that now this is running from negative time to positive infinite time, and so and therefore we have to deal with these wiggles here. So if this is our sync function here, and this is our actual symbol, and then the next one would just start, for example, here, then we had here interference between these two symbols, for example, and then this continues here. So we also had interference here. So the question is, can we fix that?